Crown Jewel as he takes on Cody Rhodes. That means that the Money in the Bank contract will be carried there by Priest, and with McIntyre and Rollins expecting a war for the World Heavyweight Championship, who knows what happens.
The most dangerous person on the roster is the person who holds the brief.
And let's not forget, Roman Reigns also defends the Undisputed Championship at Crown Jewel against LA Knight, so perhaps some opportunity for Mr. Money in the Bank. Here we go, main event tonight, McIntyre. Earlier tonight, knocked off Sami Zayn as he prepared for Seth Rollins. And now in this matchup, Damian Priest prepares for Cody Rhodes for the match against Jey Uso.
Jey Uso is starting to regret not joining the Judgment Day, realizing how difficult life can be without a unit like the Bloodline or the Judgment Day backing you up.
Well, I don't think so, and let's make no mistake about
it. Let me explain. With the Bloodline behind him, record-breaking tag championship reign, with nobody helping him out, lost the tag championship in about a week. Well, That's the difference backup makes.
You have to blame Jey's brother, Jimmy Uso, who came from out of nowhere to cost Jey and Cody the championship last week. And what a right hand by Damian Priest. Again, oozing confidence. Priest, of course, the Money in the Bank contract holder. Whipped Jey across the ring with authority. What do you think Priest is thinking about what Rhea Ripley's been doing, trying to recruit a number of superstars to the Judgment Day? Drop kick by Jey.
Look, I know a lot of people have been throwing out the word leader when it comes to Rhea Ripley. I don't think anyone in Judgment Day would quite go there, but certainly, oh.
Jey Uso leading tonight, taking out Priest. Uso on fire on Raw. Becky Lynch successfully retaining the NXT Women's Championship earlier tonight here on Monday Night Raw. Capacity crowd, American Airlines Center in Dallas, Texas. This is our main event. Jey Uso against Mr. Money in the Bank, Damian Priest of the Judgment Day.
Priest has just been brutalizing main event Jey Uso for the past 5 minutes or so, really taking its toll on the former tag champ.
You know, you mentioned something earlier, Wade, and I want to go back to it. Just the confidence that seems to ooze out of Damian Priest lately.
Yeah, you know what? When you've got gold around your waist, when you've got Judgment Judgment Day backing
and
you
broken
up.
Broken arrow from Priest, covering a kick out by Uso.
Not only that, you send your Money in the Bank. You've got a lot of things to be confident about. And when you can pull out moves like this.
Watch the broken arrow by Damian Priest, almost putting Uso away. Now the trash talking by Damian Priest. Then Judgment Day with all the gold, the tag champs, the North American champ, the women's world champ, Señor Money in the Bank. Jey Uso trying to fire back.
Trash talk might be a little too much against someone the caliber of a Jey Uso.
Yeah, Jey Uso. Again, still trying to establish himself, Wade, as a singles competitor. Spent so many years, of course, as one of the greatest tag teams of all time with his brother Jimmy. And holding his own here against Damian Priest.
I don't know if I'd want to get in a slugfest with Jey Uso at any point.
Yeah, Uso, right hands now, driving Priest back to the corner. Priest trying to keep his hands up, can't do it. And Jey Uso's feeling it.
Yeah, this is what has made Jey Uso so good over the years, this second win he's able to get.
Yeah, one of the most well-conditioned athletes in all of WWE. Priest got hung up on the top rope. He's caught. Uso makes him pay.
It's a problem with those long limbs. Get caught in the ropes very easy.
Jey now launching himself. Top rope, crossbody. Lateral press, hooks the leg. Is it enough? Kick out by Priest.
How quickly did the momentum in this match do a complete 180? Just when you start to write off Jey Uso, back on top in a big way.
And that's the problem, as you mentioned before, you can't write off Jey Uso. So many opponents believe they're in control, they relax a little bit, it allows Jey back into the match.
I mean, the guy just doesn't have an off day.
And Jey measuring his man, and Priest trying to put him in position for the Samoan drop. Priest able to shift his weight. Oh, and a big right hand.
Cleaning the clock at Jey.
Oh, and it turns Jey inside out. Cover now by Priest. Hook of the leg for the win and a kick out now by Jey.
Yeah, Jey Uso completely rocked with that combo. Perhaps starting to get a little frustrated. Oh. sound of those shots.
You just listen to the impact by Priest.
It's that limb length. Gets such a swing on all of his shots using his physique.
And Priest setting up Jey Uso, perhaps for the South of Heaven chokeslam to put Jey away. He's got Uso where he wants him. Gonna hoist him up in the air, but Uso, though, with a couple of well-placed elbows to the side of the head. Kick to the midsection. And Jey Uso feeling it.
Jey Uso gasping for air a little here.
Samoan drop.
He could
cover. Near fall by Jey.
Both men giving it all they've got, barely able to stand. This is Jey Uso at his best, almost putting away Priest with a Samoan drop.
Priest exhausted. Jey Uso as well. Battle of attrition here.
Two men with such deep arsenals, you can never guess what's coming next.
And Jey Uso now gonna fly, suicide dive. Oh, Priest though, oh, face first.
The power of Damian Priest catching Jey Uso.
A flatliner right on the announce table. And just like that, Priest has turned things around. Box in the ears of Jey, and a step up in Zaguri by the big man. And Uso with one of his own. Oh, face first again. Covered by Priest for the win, kick out.
Two heavyweight boxers slinging all they've got in the 12th round.
Again, Priest looking to build some momentum toward Crown Jewel in the battle with Cody a week from Saturday.
That confidence is starting to slip on the face of Damian Priest. What have I got to do to put this guy away?
Priest just such a physical, bruising competitor.
This might work. This is what put Cody out last week.
Yeah, through the announce table, a razor's edge, and Priest has got Jey Uso in position. Jey, though, able to slip out of it. And Jey spear! And Jey Uso now gonna go up top. Priest had the wind knocked out of him. Uso splash. Jey hooks the leg. Meanwhile, Finn Balor, the official never went down for the three count because Balor came out and distracted him.
Well, it's lucky for Damian Priest because this match was over right there.
And now Uso attacking Balor with the dive.
Jey had this match won. Of course, Priest just enough time to recover.
And now Priest and Uso slugging it out. The official trying to separate the two, and that allows Finn Balor to grab the leg of Uso. Priest, South of Heaven. And Priest steals one.
Here is your winner, Señor Money.
And Balor's not done yet. Finn Balor with his just intense personal hatred of Jey Uso.
The strength in numbers in this game. Doesn't Jey Uso know that now?
And now off the South of Heaven chokeslam into a coup de grace. Judgment Day laid waste to Jey Uso.
WWE Raw.
And I do not believe Judgment Day is done yet. Balor with a steel chair in hand.
What on earth are they cooking up here?
Well, they're going to make sure Jey Uso never competes again. Just like what they did to Rhodes earlier tonight. But speak of the devil. Cody Rhodes is hobbling on his way out to the ring after the assault by Damian Priest earlier tonight. And how wise is this for Cody Rhodes?
He's fighting on one leg right now. What are you thinking, Cody?
Cody dragging himself to the ring, wants to get himself some of Damian Priest. the chop block, suffered the hands of Cody by the gunner earlier on. And now, the chair to the midsection, into the spine of Priest.
An eye for an eye, Priest.
And now it's Cody Rhodes hammering away on Damian Priest.
A little equalizer ahead of their matchup at Crown Jewel.
Eye for an eye. Priest is helpless and now dragged out of the ring by Balor. But Cody Rhodes came out here with vengeance on his mind.
Cody Rhodes is nowhere near 100% though.
What a valiant effort by Cody Rhodes, who a week from Saturday will get his hands on Damian Priest at WWE Crown Jewel. And for Priest, there may be hell to pay after the assault on Cody Rhodes earlier tonight. We want to remind everybody that this coming Friday night, SmackDown will be on FS1. Roman Reigns, the Undisputed Champion, will be there live to sign the contract for his match with LA Knight. And also next week, right here on Monday Night Raw, the final Raw before Crown Jewel, the World Heavyweight Champion Seth Freakin' Rollins in action against J.D. McDonough, who's trying to earn an opportunity to join Judgment Day. Rhodes turns his attention to Damian Priest and Crown Jewel. Thanks for joining us, everybody. Good night from Dallas and Monday Night Raw.